Alright guys, welcome back. It's me, Daniel, VintageMagic.com, and I have something really cool here with the International Car Show in Seattle, Washington. And these are some of my favorite cars ever created.
That's it, right there.
The Lamborghini Huracan. Cabriolet. They don't call it Cabriolet, I don't think. Gallardo? Lamborghini Gallardo? And a Ferrari 458 Italia. Three exhausts in the back, but you can't tell. So yeah, I want to share this video with you guys because I don't know if you guys are car fans, but cars are just so collectible. Now, let me talk about something about collecting. This video is about more about what is the difference between so we talk about vintage cars and old school cars, stuff like that. As you guys know, cars go down in value. When you buy it off the lot, if you buy a brand new car, it's like 30 to 50% decline instantly if you buy a brand new car. But in rare cases, there's a collecting market for cars. Just like this old classics. I want to see you guys see this. This car right here, I don't know what it is. Some of the old engines. This must be, wow, it's like a lowrider. Like Snoop Dogg would drive this thing. Hey Nick, all done? Okay. Nick's in the video too. We're at the International Car Show. So these are some really old cars, vintagey cars. And sometimes these classic cars, this is actually a Chevy Impala. That's what I thought, Chevy Impala. And this is done by Seattle Custom Cars. And the idea here is sometimes in life, cars and other depreciable assets can actually be investable and collectible. And in the case of cars that are depreciable, it could actually, Nick, you gotta get out of there. No. In the case of old vintage cars, there is a market to buy these cars on premiums. I think there's like a famous auction house called Barrett Auctions in like Arizona or something. And they have incredible like vintage cars and restored cars from like some of the earliest eras of car creation. Nick, you gotta come over here. Yeah, so this is kind of cool because you never see these type of cars. Typically we see all the Fords, the Chevys, the Toyotas, Lexus, whatever. But these are like the old cars. And keep in mind, you know, this is a original Chevy lowrider. Nick, let's go, come on, let's go. We gotta go. Yeah, so keep in mind guys, see that what happens is when you have a depreciable asset, and you then like restore it or you put upgrades to it, stuff like that, it can become an appreciable asset, and then you can sell it for an auction for actually as an investment and make quite a bit of money. Now, that type of business, obviously, is kind of like reserveless cars. Sometimes you have to hold them for a very long time, and then they become very valuable in some cases due to historical levels or historical reasons. Just like cars, you know, cars signify certain types of engines, certain types of design, electronics, styling. There's certain, you know, collectors love to pay premiums for rare, expensive cars. Now, I'm not saying like your regular Chevy Impala that was overproduced, you know, is going to get those premiums. But I will say that you could definitely get those kind of premiums for cars that are old and vintage. Nick, over here. All right, let's take a look at all the cars out here. So, we have BMW down there. BMW is one of the, okay, I would say, if I was looking at that magic car relationship, okay, let's take a little bit of fun games here. BMW is what I call reserveless cards, mid-level, not quite Power 9 type of thing. Not even dual lands. I mean, yes, some dual lands here and there, unlimited dual lands. Some beta dual lands. I say beta dual lands in the sense of that, like that iDrive car right there, that BMW. It's like a $200,000 battery hybrid car. Then you have like brands like Acura. Acura is kind of, it's made by Honda, and that's kind of, they even have that car right there, the white NSX. It's like $169,000 supercar, a 0-60 like 2.8 seconds, and that car is definitely in that expensive Power 9 category also. But as a brand overall, I would say Acura is probably not quite super high-end reserveless cars consistently. obviously the high-end super reserveless cars are always gonna be Ferraris, Lamborghinis, stuff like that. And like Lexus, I don't know if you guys know, is Lexus is also, like that red car, is one of their top line cars. It's basically over $100,000. It reminds me a lot, of kind of that higher end, like a dual land, mid-level dual land. Lexus, by the way, is owned by Toyota. So you're using a lot of the same parts. So in a way, cars are collectible, but all of these cars are depreciating like crazy instantly when you buy them. Like you have the Hyundais back there. Those are, economic cars, right? Economy cars that you have that are basically investments for more practicality. And then you have the Fords that are great for practicality. They're great for heavy duty work. And you have the Chevys back there. You have the Honda, Subaru, more practical, but a little bit more performance. And all of these cars all have a practicality level to them. Yeah, can you grab, he's right there. So Jim, real quick, on my vlog, what do you think about kids? Are they tough? Are kids hard to handle, to babysit?
They're busy, and they're delightful and fun if you got the right attitude, but they're busy boys and busy
girls. You're so full of crap. This is my YouTube. You gotta be more honest. Nick, you want to num-num? Okay, let's go. Look, ready to go. Let's go.
All right,
let's walk back. All right, guys, so let's walk back over to the... Yeah.
You see this car right here, this 64 Chevy?
Yeah.
I have one of those that was maroon.
You did?
Yeah.
So how much are they? Jim, tell us.
Never should have sold.
Tell people how much these cars cost back in the day, because we don't know.
Oh, I know. It's probably $22,000, $18,000, something like that.
It's that expensive still?
Maybe $15,000. I didn't buy it. My dad bought it. I had to pay for insurance and the gas and the
like
safety and maintenance.
Okay, let's talk about numbers. Like back in the 70s, was that when you were a teenager or something? Like 70s or... Like, were you able to buy a car around the 70s?
Are you asking how old I am?
No, I'm wondering how much they cost back in the day.
It was a 64 Chevy. We bought it new. So we bought it in 64. And my dad, I forget, it was something affordable for a middle-class family. And I had to pay for the insurance, the gas, the maintenance, take care of it. And he took care of the car payments. And they weren't very much. They're under $100 a month.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
This car
right here, but it was maroon color. And it was a hot car at the time.
They have to be under 20, right? Under 20,000.
Yeah.
Back in the day, yeah.
I don't remember what it was, but it was way less than now.
What do you think about the crazy prices that you see at the car show?
You're looking at 50, 60,000 for a minimum car.
Yeah.
A nice truck or a nice car. The Chevys are 40, 45.
This is unreasonable, right? It's crazy. The price inflation, huh?
Well, people finance them for 7 years and make payments, and by the time you're done with the payments, the car is ready to go in the trash can.
My father-in-law, Jim, he's a lawyer before. I'm talking about finance and stuff. Talk about like paying interest, leveraging debt. Is it a good thing or a bad thing? What do you think?
A car is a terrible investment. You drive it off the showroom floor, it drops, 20% in value immediately?
30, 40,
yeah. Payments. If you don't pay cash for it, you got to make payments, you got to pay interest. It's interest only for a while, but I think the interest applies later. And like I said, it used to be 5 years, now it's 7 years you're paying for a car.
So what's the advice then? Is it smart for people out there buying brand new cars, or is it better to
pay cash for a real good quality 3 or 4 year old car?
A used car.
Well, maybe one that came off a lease to a corporate executive or his corporate wife. That's the way to go. No, they take really good care.
Right. Yeah. Do you ask that at the dealership? Hey, was this by a corporate wife?
Been doing for years. I got a friend of mine that goes to the auctions, and I tell him what I want. I buy the car sight unseen.
Let me ask about real estate, because you know a little about real estate. Is real estate appreciable asset, or is there ways to lose money in real estate?
Well, houses used to not go up in value hardly at all, 100 years ago. Now they've become like an investment vehicle, and everybody's looking for the gain. And selling them, it's like the Russian roulette, when people used to just buy a house and hope to pay it off and keep it, pass it down to the kids. Now it's a game. How it became that way, I don't know.
Right.
Wives started working, so everything doubled when they started bringing home the money.
When the wives, yeah, it's true though.
Oh yeah.
Right, because the demand was huge.
My mom used to stay home, and we had the guy with the diaper truck. We had the milkman come to the door, and she was home, and my dad made enough money to buy us a house and get a nice car, and I had a great bicycle. I remember that.
So the idea of the middle class, is gone, right? It used to be where you can afford things, buy a house. Yeah, right. So do you think American middle class is gone?
It's going.
It's going to be gone. Yeah. Because nowadays, if you make $100K a year, it doesn't mean anything.
Well, taxes come
out. Yeah. Yeah. It's so absurd. All right, guys. Well, there you hear. You hear from a guy who's basically 21 years old. It's on our vlog. Yeah, we're just trying to talk about. Look, we're just trying to share with people about kind of financial investing. All right, you get Nick for a second. I'm gonna close this video out. All right, guys. So that was good. That was good investing tips. Yeah, that was great investing tips.
Now you got a kid.
Yeah. Okay, come on. I'm doing a video. We're almost done. Up. I can't do up. Right. You want to buy a car? Jim, grab this. I'll get him. Hey guys, hold on a second. Ugh, I'll do the video like this.
You should be able to see your butt. Spencer's green lime colored jacket pretty easily.
Most of the times, this is what happens.
I don't see him.
My son, Nick Chang, 2 years old, he's crazy. Guys, this is what happens. When you have a business and you have the flexibility magic has brought, it's a great life, great opportunity. And we take care of the kids, it's great too. It's the best memories in the world, but sometimes it's tough. You gotta understand, the assets that you make, the decisions you make for your choices, result directly towards your family as you get older. You gotta start thinking about that early, because once you invest in stuff, you can start taking more profit and, you know, basically take time. You know, you're trading money with time, right? Basically, you wanna have that money work for you, so you have more time for the little guys like this, right? Little guys like this.
Did you see this, Dan?
The whole house. Hold on, I'm still finishing. I finished up the video. Yeah.
Yeah. Show that.
So that's what I'm trying to say, guys. Is that try to have more time with your kids. You try to focus more time, and then you know these toys that we're talking about here, they don't really mean much in the scheme of life, because ultimately, if you make more money, you spend a lot of time working, other investments. Sure, if you can afford it, that's great. You pay in cash, just like Jim just said a minute ago. That's smart, right? But if you don't pay those things in cash, you have an incredible amount of debts. No, Nick, no. What are those, like lawnmowers? No. Nick, I said no. Then you have to deal with kids like this. No, this is ow. Guys, we're in this old school display, like, Nick, up now. Sorry, guys. Cannot go there. It's like 1900s type of thing. We're gonna break. What is that, guys? Put in the comments below what that is. No, Nick. Okay, Nick just went into like some drug mafia car, and this is gangster Nick. Oh my God. What do you guys think? Snoop Dogg, Dick Dogg. Jeez. All right, guys, I don't know what to say about this. This is, what car is this, guys? Tech Specs. This is a famous car. This is a Cadillac, a 1982 Cadillac Brigham Elegance. Now Nick is just gangster rolling it. Gangster Nick. This is freaking awesome. Look at this grill, guys. When you talk about grills, I know it's like teeth, you know, like wrapping and stuff, but it's also the OG grills are in the cars. This car, not like the low riders, they're not low, but these cars must do some low riding. But this is the kind of cars you guys find back in the gangsters. They love that kind of stuff. Like the pimps, the PIMPs, they love this stuff. See guys, there's a culture in this. I know this video has a lot going on to it, but there's a culture in the cars that is unmistakable. You'll realize really quickly that cars have personality. There's customization to it. And just like your Magic the Gathering decks and investment, there's tons of things you can do with your cars, with your decks, and these investments become incredible. Like it speaks to someone, right? Because ultimately a buyer will pay a premium for those, but it's very difficult. You cannot go into the mindset, hey, I'm gonna buy all these cars and I'm gonna make a ton of money off millions of dollars of cars. That's not how it works. In collectibles market, you have to restore them, sell them, get cash flow, try to build a market for them. You have to market them. There's a lot of things that go along with it. Like this car right here, that Nick's gangster Nick's involved. It's called the Red Light District. I mean, that's what I'm talking about. These kind of cars are so expensive to restore sometimes, and they're now featured in magazines because of, you know, eras. Even though this is a 1982, it has a lot of culture into it because of the past. All right, guys, I hope you guys got something out of the video. I know there's a lot to these. crazy videos of investment, but there's a lot of messages here. Talk about investment, talk about money, we're talking about interest, talk about what? Kids? Spending time with the kids? Hi, Nick. He likes this car the best, guys. All right. Well, say bye, Nick. Bye. Say bye. Say bye. Mike, Nick, say bye to everybody. Nick, can you say bye? Nick, say bye. Nick, Mike, Nick, say bye. Okay, bye, guys. Have a great day. Bye, Nick. Bye.
No.
No? Bye.
No.